set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He'll take it from the two. He's tackled at the 23. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Number 88 was the intended receiver on the play. From their own 23-yard line. Second down. Pitches it, and he's got a lane. He gets to about the 41-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
Pitch, and he's got some room. Gets out to around the 35.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 35-yard line, first down. He scrambles. He's taken down at about the 29-yard line.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
And he's tackled at the 20. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
First and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Has some daylight. And down he goes at the 12.
That's a game on the play. That makes it second and two.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
This is picture-perfect defense by this corner. Great job of providing run support.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
So it's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Georgia Tech could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it is good. The Yellow Jackets, his quarterback taken off earlier, down on the sideline right now. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we'll see him back in the game before the day is over. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Longhorns having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback, because this kid
goes out there. He works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. He's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibilities being a go-to player.
Hands it off. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Gain of 2 on the play. That brings us 3rd and 10. Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. Here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Georgia Tech is up a field goal. So they give it to the fullback, and he's able to get him 8 on the carry. So it's 2nd down and about 2 yards to go. He is drilled at the 41. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
Complete. He's got room. Tackle made around the 34-yard line.
Brad, it's a first down. Obviously, this offense right now is trying to maintain possession, is trying to get some rhythm going, and for them to be able to pick up a big first down right here allows them to continue to try to get to the position that they ultimately want to get, and that's into the end zone.
Brought down at the 26-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
It's 2nd down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Now he pitches it. Pickup of 1 yard for the tailback. And 10. Ball on the 19. Georgia Tech is up by 3. He's going to try and scramble. Slides down to the ground.
That brings up 2nd and 1.
Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 3-0, Georgia Tech. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line.
No gain. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
It's 3rd down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Touchdown, Yellow Jackets. Oh,
this guy big and strong, but I think he's got some real speed.
And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 47-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running room.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Tackle at the 35-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He has some room. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 44-yard line. They'll bring him down at about the 43-yard line. He's tackled right around the 30. And he's taken down at the 15-yard line. Great tackle at the 23-yard line.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
So the sack makes this a second and long. At the 11. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. And he hits him hard at the 4-yard line. The stop at the 2. He's taken down right around the 2-yard line. To the running back, no good. Can the defense make a stop? Fourth down and goal to go. We're at the 1-yard line.
The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
The draw within a field goal. And he hits the PAT. A 12-play, 67-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points. Texas is ready to kick it away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Georgia Tech holds a field goal lead. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Now he tries to buy some time. There's a fumble. Recovered by the offense. And he's level at the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line, third down. He's on the run, and he's tackled at the 45. He must not have seen anybody open on that play.
Nobody open downfield, but he's got to be careful. I like his toughness, but those kind of hits are going to take a toll on him eventually.
The Longhorns struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch could get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. And he tackles them hard at the 46.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
With room to work. Steps out of bounds at about the 31.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Here they come. Fires out to his receiver. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. Receiver, touchdown. He makes the PAT. A six-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Over the middle and finds the fullback. And down he goes at the 39. From their own 39-yard line. First down. Now he's scrambling. Tackle made around the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Oklahoma!
Scrambling around. Brought down in the open field.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's halftime, and we've got a close one. 14-10, Longhorns.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic. They're very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively. How about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way if Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Very close game now as we start the second half. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Texas holds a four-point lead. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. He gets hit out of bounds at the 36-yard line. It to the 47. So the option play gets some big yards right there.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing how sometimes this guy is able to find a hole and get through it.
Easy, easy.
From their own 47-yard line, second down. Go with the run once again. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
Check three.
And he throws right away. And this one falls incomplete.
Number eight was the intended receiver on the way. That brings us fourth and 11.
Fielded at the 19. Room around the corner. Gets out to about the 31. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 46. Gets out to around the 45.
That brings up second and 9.
Gets out to about the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
First and 10, ball on the 37-yard line.
Mike three.
Blue 19.
Makes it out to about the 16. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point.
A five-play, 69-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
And it was really those long runs that really helped propel that drive.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's scrambling. Brought down at the 31-yard line. Run up the middle.
Easy, easy,
and they get nice yardage on that run. Nice run there. He might have a chance. Makes it out to about the 39. To the run game, and this time he's met immediately. Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 40. Up the middle for a nice gain. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
They'll call on the field goal unit. Texas is looking to tie things up. The kick is up. It's got the distance, and it's good.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
Good game here, 17-17. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the one. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Wow, close game here, and up and down the field with both these offenses matching what the other's done.
Well, it's fun to watch each offense get an opportunity to go out and make plays, and you're right. You almost feel as if one offense feels challenged and has to be able to bounce back, and they've done that.
I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect.
And he is drilled at the 33.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He has some room. Makes it out to about the 50.
That's a gain of 17. First down.
Pitches out, and the ball is up for grabs. It's recovered. It's second down and a long way to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. He's tackled at midfield.
Well, they get all those yards, but come up just shy of the first.
Good play call, almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
So at the end of three, this game is all tied up, 17. This final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. So early in the fourth quarter, every possession is going to count from here on out, and we're in a tie ball game. They'll bring him down around the 21-yard line. He fights forward to about the 23.
That's a gain of two. That makes it 37.
Fires it out. And they make the stop at the 30. He's to the 40. Tackle at the 43.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47.
Man, two, hey, kill, kill, kill.
And he can't get away from the pressure.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent.
Three, down.
second and 11.
Ball on the 38. Loss of one for the fullback. Just under three to go in regulation. Once and all, going deep. It's picked off, and it's the sophomore.
In a close game, the outcome often comes down to one play. Maybe that pick was it, but who knows? We've still got some football to be played.
From their own 21-yard line, it's first down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Catches it, and he's punished.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
Let's it fly. Complete. He's got room, and he's finally out of bounds at the 49. Tackled at the 29.
That makes it first and 10.
They go with the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, and especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you, and that's what happened.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. It's up, and it's good. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Yellow Jackets battled all game long, but it's not looking so good right now.
Well, but remember, they're still within striking distance here. If they can put together a drive, they got a shot to win this game.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And down he goes at the 34. Somebody jumped early down there.
False start. Offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 29. Scrambling around. Tackle made around the 35-yard line. Now he's scrambling. Slides down to the ground. Picks up about 9 on the scramble.
That brings up second and
down. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Fires incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
We have less than a minute to go. He scrambled. Room around the corner. He dives, and he'll be marked down. Georgia Tech will take their second time out of the half. From the 37-yard line, first down. He's on the run. The ball is loose. He picks it up. And they hit him in the backfield. And he stops the clock with a spike. This is the eighth play of this drive. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Brought down around the 12-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. The spike will stop the clock. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Here they come. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. This game now lies squarely on the shoulders of this kicker. If he misses, then this game is all but over. A make, and we're looking at overtime. We're going to OT. Well, we've had fun, folks, but we're not done yet because this game is heading to overtime. And here we are. We played four quarters, and we still don't have a winner, so we go to overtime.
Mike three, Mike three.
He gets out to about the eight. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown, Tech.
It can be advantageous to have the ball second in overtime, but only if you can make a stop. Now that they gave up the score, they're playing from behind with a ton of pressure on
it. He makes the PAT. From the 25-yard line, first down.
Ready, run.
Picked off, and this one is finally over. I'm sure are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.